Obaseki's intervention to make Edo State safe. Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, all depending on the time we're reaching you guys. Welcome back to our channel. So good to have you guys back here again, and thank you once again for all you do for this channel. God bless you. We really appreciate you, and we pray that even as you support this channel, God Almighty will support you in whatsoever you lay your hands to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you once again. Yes, guys, as always, we're back again with latest and most authentic happenings in the country. The security situation in the country is still a huge concern to everyone in every state, irrespective of the state. No state is safe. Even if someone feels that their state is safe enough, what about moving from your state to another? Killer Fulani herdsmen, they're still out there. Kidnapping bandits, they are still out there. So the whole country is still not safe. You know, it was yesterday that the security advisor of Nigeria, the person of Mungono, he had a meeting with the United Kingdom, all because of these same security issues. You know, the international society, they've been raising concerns, worries, because, you know, they have their own citizens in the country as well, so they have to be concerned. They are watching and even asking questions. What is the federal government doing? What steps have they put in place? That was why yesterday they had a security dialogue, and it's still ongoing. Well, Governor Godwin Obaseki has been doing a lot in the state, but, you know, of late, the people of his state have been making demands that the open grazing bill that the southern governors agreed to, that they should all sign. Up to now, the governor has still not signed it. And but, you know, he gave his excuses, but those excuses did not sit well with the people. But the governor is still insisting that the security of the people, the safety of the people, is at the core of his administration. We'll bring you all of the details, all he's doing right now, his interventions to make Edo State great. We'll bring those details to you in a bit. But before we do, guys, please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, click on the like button. And if it's your first time, you're very welcome. Please hit on the subscribe button. God bless you. Now to the news. The uncompromised safety of Edo residents is at the core of the Governor Godwin Obaseki's administration. While the issue of security in Edo State has been painted with diverse political colorations, many residents of the state can testify that the state remains one of the most peaceful in the country. This rating stemmed from the state government's effort in making Edo uninhabitable for criminals. Besides setting up a comprehensive security architecture and network, including a well-equipped network of local vigilantes, Obaseki has demonstrated unwavering commitment towards the welfare of Edo people by elevating and boosting security in the state through the deployment of crime-fighting technology. Today, the Edo State Command and Control Center is fully digitized, granting citizens direct access to government in times of distress. The Obaseki administration has maintained its grip on sustaining and improving a peaceful and business-friendly atmosphere in the state. The influx of criminal elements from the neighboring states has been tackled with adequate security measures, as Edo State today remains the safest state in the south-south region of the country. Threats to peace in the state, such as banditry, kidnapping, terrorism, and other forms of social vices, have been nipped in the bud. Despite the fact that the security is on the exclusive legislative list, Obaseki found a way to strengthen partnership with the federal security agencies right from the onset of his administration, when he set up Operation Wabazinga, which has input from the local vigilante network. The security outfit relies on information and intelligence from the people. According to Obaseki, any security strategy that does not involve the people on ground in the various communities will not succeed. Obaseki adopted this strategy of incorporating the local vigilante network into the security architecture to protect Edo people from the activities of bandits, terrorists, and other criminal elements. However, while the government is saddled with the responsibility of providing the right administrative framework for security and dispensation of justice to all who are found wanting, as well as setting in place structures geared towards curbing crimes and criminality, The public owes the state a duty to report and expose criminals in their domains at all times. The vigilante network has been largely localized by the Obaseki administration to enable easy information exchange between residents and security agencies. The Edo State Command and Control Center has been put in place to grant the public access to quick response in case of an emergency. This has created a synergy between the government and the people, contributing immensely to the mitigation of criminal activities in the state. It is, however, the desire of the Obaseki administration to see to the eradication of crime in Edo State. The approach so far adopted by the Edo State government towards security in the state is a fundamental part of the master plan to make Edo safe for all. We've been told now that the safety of Edo residents is at the core of the governor of Obaseki's administration, meaning that everything he does is geared to ensuring that the people are safe. You know, for government officials, for political office holders, they have their own form of security, and which is not fair on the masses. Not everyone can afford a policeman or an escort, oddly, to go with them everywhere they are going to. But these politicians, they all have access to that. Obaseki is stating that his mission is to ensure that everyone is safe. So not just that himself is safe alone, or his cabinet or those working with him. The masses, everyone is safe, and is putting in place different things, the vigilante, and even working with other security stakeholders, form the a security architecture. But you know what? The people are still telling the governor that what he needs to do is to join his colleagues, the southern governors, because they all unanimously agreed that this will help. If he's truly working towards this, then that will be something that he needs to look into, not just put in one corner, you know, because his excuse was that there is no measure in place yet to deal with the defaulters. So if they say no open grazing, and the herdsmen are still grazing openly, that how would they be dealt with? But you know, he was told that leave that one first, just sign the bill. When you sign the bill, that one will follow suit. I mean, the people respect him a lot. They respect the governor a lot. As a matter of fact, they gave him their vote even after he left the All Progressive Congress because of his developmental stride and all he's been doing for the state. But this one thing is something that they are kind of looking at and waiting, that what will he do finally? You know, we've been told now that he's been doing a lot of things, but that one is still standing and is something he needs to look into. Anyway, guys, let's hear your own thoughts. Thank you once again for staying tuned. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Till I come your way again with more updates. Bye.